Pablo Picasso is considered, you know, pretty avant in his time. But before his death, a painting was brought in front of him from the dealers in Paris as a gift. And Mrs. Picasso was wondering whether she should buy it for him, but if he liked the Cezanne, what have they done to this poor Cezanne? What have they done to poor Cezanne? He saw they had been annihilated in cleaning. You see, but he took him 15 to 20 minutes to drink it in, till finally he couldn't stand another minute and then turn around and look at it. See, an artist does that. A real artist senses these.
Sistina is the taste of the 80s. It's as clear as a bell. Just think about the 1980s and other things. The robber barons, the junk bonds. That's what the Sistina is.
The thing that I used to lay on the floor as an artist, when I lived in Rome, I'd go over early in the morning, they let me in the bottom, long before these people came along in the 50s, and I used to see the morning sun bounce in, and I could see the whole ceiling. And it's true, there was a slight grayish tone, which was the glue. But it was the hand of Michelangelo from beginning to end over the ceiling. It was a terrifying experience, and it was the superhuman, and it left in me, I'm a believer in Christ, and it was the Holy Ghost. I felt the Holy Ghost on that ceiling. And I said, I don't feel it now. It's vignettes, it's very pretty, and this is a crime against humanity.
If the damage done to the great works of art at the Met, the National Gallery, and all over the world were lost skirmishes to those who spoke out against them, then the Sistine Chapel was the most futile of all battles to date.
I was teaching Michelangelo in my survey class on Italian Renaissance painting. I realized that something was very amiss, and I got quite upset in class because I was putting up on the screen, and I vowed to myself and to the class that I would go immediately to Rome and to the Sistine ceiling and check it out. And so that May, towards the end of May, I went to Rome. It was 1986, and I went with the director of works, and he showed me what he was doing with great pride, and I was appalled. And I asked that man about the dating of the layers, and I said, what was this first layer? And he said, oh, that's probably 18th century, and we're taking that off. And then I said, well, what about the layer underneath it, which was attached to the actual painting? And I said, when was that made? And he said, I don't know when that was made, but we're taking that off too. And he said to me, Professor Beck, what do you think of all this? And I said, I believe what the painters have been saying. And these are his words. The painters? What do the painters know about painting?